I think this week's series of events for Mental Health Awareness Week has been amazing. We've never done anything like this before. We've had 8 different partners get together to look at employment, education, health, policing, youth. It's great because we need to raise awareness, we need to remove stigmas and make the public more aware of what we do, celebrate the good stuff and actually admit that we're not getting it right in other areas and learn from those mistakes and get better.
It is my honour to host these events at Bournemouth University this week, along with colleagues like James Polfram and Kay. And I think what it really has illustrated is indeed that partnership with, in addition to the university, Dorset Police and Crime Commissioner, Dorset Healthcare University Foundation Trust, and all the other partners, Dorset Police, Bournemouth Borough Council. Across the week, it's been a phenomenal joint effort to bring these talks together.
Well, that first conversation is absolutely vital. So it's vital for those of us with mental health problems to talk to somebody, whether it's a friend, a family member, a partner, or the GP. You've got to talk to someone about it first. And then from our friends and family's perspectives and our line managers, our colleagues, you don't be afraid to have a conversation. Just show that you care by asking someone how they are. You don't have to have all the answers, but just start the conversation.
The opportunity to work in partnership with Dorset Police and Criminal Justice Services has been an overwhelming privilege. Working in co-location in police custody and court settings has provided services with immediate intervention to presenting vulnerabilities that have led to a greater identification of their needs and thereafter referral onto health and social care agencies.
What's changed in Dorset Police now? We're better equipped at working with partners that are involved in the mental health. We have Bournemouth University come in to assist us with training. We managed to weave training into our first aid training for mental health. We also work with Dorset Mental Health Forum and deliver training to victims of crime who've got mental illness and better equip them so that they can feel safe and make better informed choices as they go forward. There's still quite a bit of work to be done, no doubt about it, but I feel a lot more positive than where we were 18 months ago, and barriers are being broken down.
I think up until now it's been operating in silos, particularly between mental health and police, where too many people end up in police cells, for example, but then also between mental health services and schools. We need to bring these services together. These are all publicly funded. They need to collaborate closely together with everyone focusing on prevention and building resilience. And I think with that sort of partnership, we can make a real difference and make much better use of public money.